Good morning, America. I'm Joan London.
And I'm Forrest Sawyer. It is Wednesday, July 11th. Ahead this morning, lasers have been hyped as the knife of light for cosmetic surgery, but experts warn high tech may mean high risk.
Going for opera's Golden American takes first place in one of the world's most prestigious musical competitions.
And the looniest larynx in Toontown, impressionist Jeff Bergman, is the new voice behind Bugs Bunny, George Jetson, and a pack of other characters. He'll be right along. Spencer?
Well, Forrest, today's weather map has a split personality. Sometimes hot, sometimes cool.
It's now 10 minutes past 8 o'clock. You may have seen some of the recent claims that lasers have revolutionized plastic surgery, reducing or even eliminating the pain and all the swelling and bruising that usually results. Well, this morning, the American Society of Plastic and Reconstructive Surgeons is releasing its position on the use of lasers. And joining us now on the Society's behalf is Dr. Joel Noe, Associate Professor of Plastic and Reconstructive Surgery at Harvard Medical School and a laser surgeon at Beth Israel Hospital of Boston. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Forrest.
Boy, it sure sounds good. Painless, more or less, and all those side effects are reduced. Is that true?
I don't believe so. Our position is that there is no evidence that there are significant benefits from using a laser to do a facelift or to perform cosmetic eye surgery. In fact, lasers add additional risks and extra costs to those procedures.
Then what's all this talk? Why is everybody getting all excited about it?
I think it's marketing, Forrest. I don't think there's any evidence that it's a good thing.
Do most physicians accept your position at this point?
I think most physicians who are members of the American Society of Plastic and Reconstructive Surgeons do.
All right, now when we talk about lasers, we're really talking about high energy beams of light.
Right.
Now, what exactly do they do?
A laser is a device that generates a very intense beam of light. That light is 150,000 times more powerful than sunlight. Hmm. If you have a person, such as President Gorbachev, who has a birthmark, an argon laser, for example, emits a blue light. That light is selectively absorbed by the color red. So we would shine a blue light on his forehead. The red color of the birthmark would absorb the blue light. The energy would change from light to heat, and the heat would destroy the birthmark.
But what about with eye surgery? Are they using the laser to actually do some cutting around the eyes?
Yes, they're using the laser to do cosmetic surgery on the eyelid.
And that's dangerous because?
It's because that laser is so powerful that if the beam is misdirected or goes astray, it can blind the eye, it can damage the skin. In addition, it can cause a fire.
Now, you've talked about one way in which lasers actually are used, and you use them.
Yes, sir.
Right? And that's to reduce, say, a birthmark or something
yes.
like that. Are there other ways in which you think that they're effective to be used right now?
Yes. In plastic surgery, you can use them to treat skin cancers. You can use them to treat small vessels that occur on our face from the sun or after having a rhinoplasty, a nose procedure.
Now, what do they do when you're trying to treat, say, the vessels in your skin, which a lot of us are concerned about?
They make those vessels disappear.
That's much better than any kind of cosmetic approach.
Yes, sir.
Now, down the road, do you see a possibility that lasers could have the kinds of uses that they're talking about right now?
Yes, I do, but I think a lot more work must be done. Controlled medical studies must be done throughout this country to show that the benefits outweigh the risks and the complications.
Haven't there been any studies so far?
There was one study at Stanford University Medical Center. They took 10 patients that were having cosmetic eyelid surgery. On one side, they used the laser, and on the other side, they used a scalpel. They asked all the patients to evaluate their results. None of the patients could tell any difference. They had a physician who hadn't participated in the surgery evaluate the results also, and he could not see any difference between the sides.
So give us a little advice now. If we're thinking about having some kind of plastic or reconstructive work done, to whom should we speak and what care should we take in going about this procedure?
Well, you can call the American Society of Plastic and Reconstructive Surgeons. They have an 800 number to get the names of plastic surgeons in your area. Consumers, to protect themselves, should check with their local accredited hospital to see which plastic surgeons are credentialed, are certified, are approved by those hospitals to use lasers and use them safely.
And right now, your advice is if somebody says, let's try lasers on a little eye work here, you would say?
I would wait, sir.
Dr. Noe, you're very kind to come by this morning.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you for having me.
You bet.